into the public boat ramp here at Lake Fork. I got permission to cruise in. This is where the 2024 Bassmaster guys are fishing. I gotta get this window closed. So this is where they're launching this morning. That's one great thing about being a no-caffeiner. I can get up and go. So it was a long drive for me to get over here, but really it's close, but it is a long drive, but close enough for me to get here. I'm gonna get some footage for the channel and for some other folks, some buddies of mine that are bass enthusiasts. So we're gonna check this out. They have this big State of Texas Lone Star gazebo, and it's like a 6-lane boat ramp. All right. We're pulling in here. I will get back in touch with you guys in just a minute. All right, guys. Check it out. They're all ready to launch. They got to get all the boats in, and then they'll let them go. I'm going to get down here, try to get a little closer. We'll see how it all goes. That's good stuff. His own Ben Milliken. He's got a good chance today.
And his lived up to the legend here this week. The best thing is, most people predicting it just gets better.
Our there's the 402.
19-year-old Trey McKinney, how are you feeling this morning?
I saw the youngest one,
the little one
was with you.
Yeah, we got some
every single day.
Good luck. We'll be cheering for you. Show me the whistling.
Official time, 6:52, going to get going in 8 minutes time. A beautiful Texas sunrise for us this morning, once again proving that the office with the best view has no windows whatsoever.
His first flight's going to start here in just a minute. Look at that sunrise.
Official time, 6:55. I'd like to put the honors over here for our DJ to introduce our invocation.
Okay, we have J.D. Blackburn. He's going to do the invocation. And following, we're going to have James Blackman singing the national anthem.
Let's pray. Good morning, Father. Thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for this beautiful place. Thank you for this beautiful lake. We thank you for the sunrise. We're reminded that your mercies are new each day. We thank you for the sport of fishing, Father. It's a sport that we found when we were all little, and we thank you for the wonder and excitement that it gives us. I pray, Father, that we can always enjoy it like little children. And as little children, may we come to you humbly with amazement and awe because you are awesome. We pray for the safety of all these anglers, the cameramen that are out there today, all the hard work that goes into these tournaments. We thank you for them. We want to lift up the family of Miles Berghoff, his daughter Riley, and her battle with cancer. I pray that you will heal her completely. We also pray for our brother James Overstreet. I pray that you will give him a full recovery and he can be back out here with us. Thank you so much again for this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streamed. In the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free, in the home of the
a minute and a half away from takeoff. Anglers are going to be led out in order of placing. 10 seconds.
10 seconds.
This is the AFCO Bassmaster Elite at Lake Fork. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Leading them out, the youngest angler ever to qualify for the Bassmaster Elite Series, 19-year-old Trey McKinney. Right behind him, a former Bass Nation national champion from Hawaii. Say aloha to Matty Wong.
Let's go, Matty.
A former Forest Wood Cup champion. He's a Bassmaster Open winner from Alabama, Justin Atkins. He's your day one leader, a four-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier. He's an Elite Series champion from Japan, Takumi Ito. Right behind him, an Elite Series champion and a five-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Louisiana, Tyler Rivets.
There they go.
He is the 2023 Bassmaster Open EQ Angler of the Year, JT Tompkins. Right behind him, a two-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Alabama, Justin Hamner. Another Elite Series rookie, he's a Bassmaster Open winner. He's a Bassmaster Classic qualifier. The only Elite Series qualifier ever from Maine, Tyler Williams. From one rookie to another, he's a Bassmaster Open winner and a Classic qualifier. From Cooperstown, New York, Kyle Patrick. A two-time Classic qualifier, a Bassmaster Open winner. That's from Bowmanville, Ontario, Canada, Cooper Gallant. Another Elite Series a rookie.
Let's go, Cooper.
Proud member of Team Yamaha, Wesley Gore. Right behind him, a social media superstar, a million followers, 500,000 followers on YouTube. He is a Bassmaster Open winner, a Classic qualifier. Originally from Nebraska, now makes his home in Texas, Ben Milliken. Right behind him, a four-time Canadian Open champion, a five-time Classic qualifier, and a Bassmaster Open winner, rolling out in the power pole, wrapped Ranger Mercury, Corey Johnston. He's an Elite Series champion, a five-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier, and the youngest angler ever win an FLW Tour event, Stetson Blaylock. He's an Elite Series champion and the back-to-back Bass Nation national champion from Alabama, Will Davis Jr.
once they get out there, boy, they just go
champion,
forward.
A two-time Elite Series champion from Connecticut, Paul Mueller. The first Canadian ever to win an FLW Tour event. The first Canadian ever to win a Bassmaster Elite Series event from Peterborough, Ontario, Canada. Chris Johnston. He's a former college bass champion, a Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Tennessee. Jacob Fouts. He's a five-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier. He is the back-to-back Bassmaster Classic champion from Coleman, Alabama. Jordan Lee.
Let's go, Jordan.
He's your reigning Progressive Bassmaster Angler of the Year from Alabama, Stone Cold Kyle Welcher. He's an Elite Series rookie, but already won $1 million casting for bass. A proud member of Team Nitro, Team Mercury from Alabama, Logan Parks. Had his family drive all night to watch this. I'm ready to put a show on. His second season on the Bassmaster Elite Series from Wisconsin, Kyle Norsetter. In his rookie season, he made 5 top 10s. He is a 2-time Elite Series winner from Japan, Kyoya Fujita. Right behind him, a 7-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier, former Dakota Lithium Rookie of the Year, Brandon Card. Also an Elite Series rookie, a former Classic qualifier, a former college bass champion, John Garrett. That concludes our first flight takeoff. We're going to wait here for a few minutes and get them going at 7:15 this morning. 7:15 this morning, we'll get them going. So if we can get our boats in order and ready, we're going to get going at 7:15.
Here goes Patrick Walters, all these guys, flight two getting ready. There's Hank Cherry right there. First flight's already gone, second flight getting ready.
Legendary Lake Forest.
Second flight.
Going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Leading out our second flight. Pulled out in the blaster-wrapped Ranger Mercury, Jonathan Kelly. Right behind him, a 4-time Bassmaster winner from Somerville, South Carolina, Patrick Walters. A 6-time Bassmaster winner, 2-time Progressive Bassmaster Angler of the Year, former Bass Nation National Champion from Rathdrum, Idaho, the prodigy, Brandon Polinick.
It was Brandon.
He's a 2-time Elite Series champion, took up one of those victories right here on Lake Fork. He's a 5-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Greenwood, South Carolina, the COBB, Brandon Cobb. A 2-time Bassmaster winner and a former Progressive Bassmaster Angler of the Year from Newmarket, Minnesota, the amazing fighter man, Seth Bider. A 3-time Bassmaster winner, 3-time TTBC winner from Huntington, Texas, Keith Combs. He's an 8-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier. He's a 4-time Bassmaster winner from North Prince George, Virginia, Jacob Porosnik. A Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. A proud member of Team Skeeter, Team Yamaha, Derek Hudnall. He's a 4-time Bassmaster winner, the back-to-back Bassmaster Classic champion from Mason, North Carolina, Hank Sherry. A 5-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Baby Shark, Shane Lanyu. A 2-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from North Carolina, KJ Queen. He's a former Dakota Lithium Rookie of the Year. He's an Elite Series champion rolling out in the AFCO Rep Skeeter Yamaha, Drew Cook. A 4-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Hubbardstown, Ohio, Hunter Tryon. Another former Dakota Lithium Rookie of the Year. He's an Elite Series champion from Wisconsin, Chase Shikurat. Had a giant day yesterday, looking to keep that rolling. He's a 2-time Elite Series champion from Chattanooga, Tennessee, Buddy Gross. A 3-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier, former Bassmaster College Bass champion.
God, look at that. They all just hit the water and they just fly. Looking for their spots.
Louisiana, the Hack Attack, Greg Packney. He's an 8-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier.
There they they go, riding off into the sunrise.
Dangerous one, Chris Salvain. Five-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier and a two-time Elite Series champion from Aiken, South Carolina, the Tower of Power. Today we're into the women's division. A six-time Classic qualifier.
Well, they just turn it loose.
Classic in just a few weeks' time. The all-time record for the biggest shoe, but they weighed a smallmouth bass.
Second flight into the sunrise. Check that out, boy. They just hit the water and go.
Here's our bubble boy. Nowhere to go but up. Bassmaster Classic qualifier. Cool fan. 50 anglers battling out on legendary Lake Morton. What a lake it has been here this week. An incredible event. Giant fish. And the question is, if we'll see century belt, the question is, how many people? Many people predict the entire top 10 will have century belt.
It's going to be a lot of fun to watch. Watch it all day long on FF1 at Bassmaster.com. There they go, guys. There they go. All right, so they've got the, what is it, 7 hours, 8 hours to fish? And then they come back in and weigh in, and I'll show you the little weigh-in area over here. Check this out here at Lake Fork, guys. This is where they do the weigh-in. But that's where they bring them in. And once they weigh the fish, then they drop them right in the water. Right back there, so they get them back in. Let's cruise around and take a look and see who all these sponsors are in the fan zone. AFTCO. Toyota. Dakota Lithium. Mercury demo boats. Whoo! Yamaha. Well, you got fishermen zipping around all over trying to find their spots out there. More Toyota. Then over here we got Power Pole. Hey, a cornhole. Garmin. Lake Fork Tackle. Look at this, Bill Lewis. Lake Fork. All the things. Okay, guys. Let's take a look at the wraps. That's Atkins. There's Drew Benton's. We'll get down a little further so we can see them. Guys, let's check out the wraps for the trucks. Everybody wants to see them. There's Kyle's. Man, that's a sick rig. I'm a GMC guy myself. But check out these. There's Wesley Gore. Man, they're just so cool. There's Tyler's. Jacobs. Check that out. It's good stuff. It looks like Cooper Gallant pulled in over there to get some repairs, maybe. Lose! There we go. It's my fishing brand. Here's another lose. I gotta watch the mud here. Some of these guys I don't know because they don't have their names on them. There's Stetson Blaylocks. Check that out. H2O. Booyah. That's good. Abu Garcia. There's Logan Parks. Corey Johnson with 6 cents. Man, Man, this is cool. There's old Hank Cherries. We got a few more down here. We'll see if we can find a few more. That's cool stuff right there. Welcome back, fishing friends, to another adventure. This is more of a super delayed intro, but you'll see the footage coming up of the flights here at Lake Fork 2024 Bassmaster Series. I've had a good time this morning. It's with the Pinhook Fishing Club. I've got Mercer, and he's here. He addressed the launch this morning, the flights. And can you give us a quick rundown of what you think the bags will be today?
All week, people. I mean, it's Lake Fork. The rules don't apply here. Like, there was people who caught 20 pounds, which a 20-pound limit at five fish. I mean, that's all across the country. That's, you've done well. 20 pounds sent you home here this week. You needed 23 pounds a day to make the top 50. Everybody inside the top 30 is on pace to make 100 pounds over 4 days. I think we're going to see a 40-pound bag here this weekend, because all week the conditions haven't been perfect. I mean, a little colder, a big cold front rolled in, there was a lot of wind. We got a lot less wind, and we got sunshine the next 2 days. So I think we're going to see, I think everybody that makes the top 10 here on Sunday is going to have over 100 pounds.
All right. Thank you very much, sir.
No problem.
Pleasure. Huge thank you to Mr. Mercer for taking the time to visit with us. That is a huge thrill for me. And I was checking out the ramps because I think it was Cooper Gallant had some boat trouble and he was launching. And then I looked at some people there that were standing there and I wanted to ask him what's the procedure for all this. And two people zipped away. And then I had to look for a minute. I was like, oh my gosh, that's Mr. Mercer. And so he was so kind. He made a video so that I could show my kiddos at school. And then that one won't be online because I'll just show that to the kids, you know, about getting into fishing and stuff. And then I did one with him that you saw. So that was cool that he took the time to do that. Man, it's just a gorgeous morning. These dudes are going to be able to catch some fish today. Good stuff. Anyway, so they're out there fishing. Good luck to them all. Check it out, guys. There's a boat ramp. I'm just kind of sitting over here. There's a beautiful walkway. And the fish are busting right in here on the surface. I got my fishing gear, so technically I could come down to the water and fish and they wouldn't mind. They let me fish. So I may do that. But I just want to give you a quick look there, the flags. This is where all the guys were staged ready for launch. So I'm waiting here a little bit because there's a fan zone behind me. And that's where I was earlier with some of that footage. It's not open yet. So we'll go check that out. But that was pretty cool. Check that out, guys. It's just so simple. You got the water, the lake here at Lake Fork, and look at that, the slides of where these anglers pulled their boats in waiting for the official launch this morning, flights as they call them. So they were all lined up in here. A couple of the guys that I wanted to find were I didn't want to get them on camera because they're trying to do their job. But like Cooper Gallant, Mark Menendez, Seth Fighter, and of course Ben. I did happen to see Ben there. But, you know, there's a lot of media around here, so I didn't want to be just another, you know, annoyance. But Hank Cherry and those guys, all the boats were lined up right here. Yeah, that's good stuff. I learned quite a bit, you know, I'd never been through this before. So here's another one. So I've never seen or been a part of anything like this. So for me, this is a big deal. And good stuff. I'm going to get something to drink, then I'm going to go over to the fan zone. So let's go check that out a little bit later. All right, guys, here we are at Lake Fork. The live magic shad, which I've just been hammered by northern pike. That was before my YouTube stuff. But these baits are phenomenal, and for bass too. And here we have Miss
Crystal,
and she's going to tell us a little more about it.
So we have four sizes on our live magic shad, and we also have two styles. On the other side is our V-tail. Here is our boot tail. It comes in a 3.5 and a 4.5, and then we have 5.5s and 8-inch swim baits as well. They're only in the V-tail. And then we have our swim bait hooks that are partnered to go with them. 3-0, 5-0, 7-0, and a 10-0.
Oh, and the spoons too, because these work good for pike up north.
Flutter spoons, our wacky weighting system. Okay, that's a really good thing if you do wacky worm fishing. There's frog tail hooks. If you throw hollow body frogs, there's a lot of opportunities for missed strikes on hollow body frogs. You put on the back, so your back two hooks that come up, you put that right there on those, and it comes out of a trailer hook. And guaranteed.
Wait a minute, say that again, because I do have trouble with my hollow bodies.
So your hollow body frog set up, you know, these two right here will go on those two hooks that come up on your frog.
Okay.
And then that's going to trail behind it. So when they come up to strike at that hollow body frog, most of the time you react and you jerk, and you're going to pull it out of their mouth before those hooks really get into them.
Mm-hmm.
So this trailer hook is back there, and that's going to snag them and give you time to get your hook set in better. Okay.
And is it still semi-weedless where they get stuck down in there?
No, it's still weedless. So they sit up on those there. It's going to raise it up high enough that, until they react and bite on it. And that just gives you time to get on there.
Oh, I'm definitely buying a couple of those today. I've got to, for sure. All right, well, thank you. Let me take a look at this other side here. And then...
Those are all the 3.5s and 4.5s in the V-tail. Three and a half, 4.5, and the 5.5 and 7.
Which is your best color, do you think? Everyone likes green pumpkin, right?
So green pumpkin is always a solid. One of our good colors lately has been tilapia. Mm-hmm. It's been doing really good, and we've came out with a new color called...
Black ones do well, too.
California 420. I don't think we have it. I think it's over in the boot sale.
Yeah, okay.
Bourbon Street is doing really good.
Let me check that out. Yep. So, I have so much success on straight black a lot of times.
Well, it's black. It has gold, purple, and green flake in it.
Oh, yeah.
It does real good. Sun perch, fire perch.
I'm trying to think if I had more luck on the split tail or the boot tail.
It's user preference, really. So the V-tail is going to be smoother and go through the water easier. Yeah. The boot tail is going to cause more of a disturbance and pick up the water more.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm definitely going to grab some for sure.
My favorite go-to bait is our hyper stick. It's our version of a Cinco.
And which one's that one?
They're over here on this other side. All of these three here, all the way down, are hyper sticks. All of those are our ring fries. That was one of our original baits. So my go-to bait is our Black Magic hyper stick. And I throw mine weightless or on a shaky head. And
black is
what
I'm telling you, black gets it done.
Yeah.
And these are like the original French fry looking deals, right?
Yes, sir. That's our original ring fry.
And you could put like a little peg weight in there and...
Yep.
Do all kinds
of
crazy stuff.
You can do everything with that. You can Texas rig it, Carolina rig it. You can wacky it. You can do anything with that. And so it goes real good with that wacky hook and weight system.
Yeah.
So you can get that in there, rig that up through it, and throw it wacky style. And it's amazing.
That's good stuff.
This past week, our Bourbon Street hyper stick, one of our local guides, he had a day before yesterday, they caught 37 fish, and most of them came from that.
That's good stuff.
Their best.
Did he rig it wacky rig style with that?
I believe they were throwing it weightless.
Oh yeah, that's good. Good stuff. All right. Well, thank you. I'm gonna grab a few packs of these.
You're welcome.
For sure. Check it out, guys. There's the big stage. When the guys come in, they got all the fresh water aerators, and they're the tanks for the fish. It's pretty good. They're starting to roll in. closing time, weigh-in and all that good stuff is coming up. Boy, look, they're just zipping along. That's cool. Just like they were took off for the flight, now they're returning home. It's a beautiful day. Here we go. There's old Ben. Woo, check that out. He's got his fish. He's going to take it up to the stage. I know you guys can't see anything. It's tough to see. His stats are. We'll see. They got a cart ready and waiting for him to haul his catches in. Some of them are starting to roll in. Check out that rig. There's Logan. There's a view of all the boats. That's just so cool of them coming in. There's Kyokyo Fujita. Mark Menendez. They're rolling in. It's good stuff. All right, guys, got a couple autographs. Thrilled. That was awesome stuff. Too old to get autographs, but on a bomber, gotta do it. So I got it signed by Mark Menendez, Jacob Howitz. That's good stuff. They're all going in to get something to eat and getting something to drink.
Quail eggs to catch the big ones here. So I got a next tournament, I got to find Milliken's boat and maybe get an egg or two. Pizza's not the deal, it's the quail eggs, trust me. But man, this lake has got big fish. It's, I hope we come back. This is a great facility. Honestly, this is one of the nicest places we come to. This is a great crowd. I think tomorrow's going to be awesome. Man, we got to come back. This lake is, I mean, it's got big ones. I've seen a couple today. I still, I don't know. I don't have, like I said, I need quail egg. And I couldn't get the big ones to bite. But I'm going to steal the quail egg for the classic. See what happens.
All right. Well, good luck with your quail eggs. He's an Elite Series rookie, a Bassmaster Open winner, and a classic qualifier from Cooperstown, New York, Kyle Patrick. Today, a big day.
They're the anglers getting ready to go in and get their weights and all that stuff and refreshments and sit and visit. All right, guys, here's more footage of the behind the scenes. People running around, going through, checking stuff out. Anglers weighing in, getting their stuff in. Cool stuff to see how it all works. Behind the scenes here. Getting a look at all the anglers. This area where they got all the water, all the fish. Checking everything in, they're getting beverages. There they are. You got Hackney, you got Kelly. Got Queen, Menendez, Holinick, all the guys standing right there. Good stuff.
Okay, send me a P.O. box or whatever. He's got a couple things. He's got something he's making for you, but he's gonna send you a couple things.
Amazing, thank you very much.
All right, brother.
Yeah. Let's do it.
You sign a bomber for me?
Sign a what?
A bomber?
Yeah, dog.
Hey, I tagged you to a couple of sunrise exits this morning.
Not
from Pinhook Fishing Club.
Pinhook Fishing Club.
Yeah, I'm a school teacher here in town.
Very nice.
So,
man.
Up near, more towards Frisco, that area.
I got you, yeah. That's
good
awesome.
Good stuff, good stuff. But I spend my summers in Iowa fishing up there all the time.
Where do you go in Iowa? Okay, yeah.
Small rivers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, a lot of smallies. And I head over to the Mississippi.
Yeah.
But, so how was it out there?
We're at here?
Yeah, out here.
Tough, actually. Really tough. I pulled a 2-pounder with a 9.5-pounder at the end of the day, so got me up to 29.
Yeah, awesome. They're starting to loosen up now, I think. They're
Man,
starting
they need to. They need to do something for tomorrow.
All right, well, hey, congrats. All right, guys, there's Ben Milliken. He signed my bomber. Good stuff, so it all worked out. He's saying wonderful things to wonderful people, taking the time to sign autographs and stuff. Such a gentleman, such a gentleman. Check out the drone. That is cool. There's Kayoka Fujita. And he's a good fisherman. He's a good fisherman. It's Kayoka Fujita with his check right there. That's good stuff. Now, these people are so nice. They take the time to sign autographs, visit with people. Bassmaster does just a quality stuff here. Treatment of everyone. You feel like a superstar no matter who you are. It's cool stuff. There's Ito, guys. He just pulled his boat out. Hey, everybody. I'm here with Mr. Ito. Can you tell us how it went in the tournament today?
Yes. I'm Taku Ito, Bassmaster Pro. So today, pretty hard day, 17-6. I think that's 21 place, 21st mm-hmm. place, yes. But still, good tournament for me.
Yes. Yeah. And the weather's not, it got hot this afternoon,
but earlier
today it was nice and cool.
Yeah.
So you had to be able to adjust to that.
Yeah. So I like a cold weather, the warming up shallow, fish shallow coming up. Mm-hmm. So.
Yes.
The day one is that also 39, but yeah.
Well, it's nice to meet you. Is there anything you want to say for any Japanese viewers that may watch?
Yeah. Japanese?
Yes.
Minasan, konnichiwa, Ito Takumi desu. Konkai no Lake Fork wa 21 deshita. Mata ganbarimasu. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah. Hey, thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Have a good one.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Here we are. So what'd you think out there?
I think this is an incredible lake, and I just kind of butchered it up on the first day. We'd be fishing tomorrow. You know, it here, if you don't have over 30, you really ain't got a bag right now this week. But it's an incredible lake, and it's one y'all need to take care of.
Did you see anybody scoping out there? Was everybody scoping?
Everybody was scoping. And I did not. I power poled down and found a hard spot and went fishing.
Okay, cool. Is it okay to ask what kind of lures you were using, or is that toxic?
I just threw all moving baits. The first day I was throwing a jig, and then I moved over to a moving bait just so I covered more water, but that was it. It was pretty fast and furious for me, and everything was over by 9 o'clock, so then after that I just tried to...
Oh, really? 9? Wow. So it was nice and cool. I was here when I'd never seen them take flight before.
Yeah.
So that was cool, and then it was cool, and then I'm sure out there on the water with the wind blowing, and then now...
You have to go through 3 changes of clothes every day, but it was a good day.
Oh, man. Man, all right. Is it okay if I pan over here? I don't want to reveal any...
Absolutely. Take that for seven.
All right, guys. Here's his boat. The world-famous Buddy. What kind of rods are you using?
Fitzgerald.
Really?
Fitzgerald fishing, yes, sir.
All right, man. Oh, yeah. There we go.
Fish drill fishing. Shimano reels.
All right, man.
Nice to meet you.
Yes, nice to meet you. All right, guys. There's a couple of the trucks left. I'm about to sign off here. It was a lot of fun. Never been through an experience like this, so this was pretty cool. All right, guys. Until next time, I will see you then. Bye-bye. Now get out there and get your lures wet.